Okay, so now we will use the final element method to design the same slab. You seen before, last time you were the table to calculate bending moment. Now we will use the final element method. So here I will use ETABS. Matrix. Okay, concrete design. You put your code. And then, in our example, we have in iteration we have two grid. We have 1, 2, 3, 5 meter, 5 meter each. So here in iteration, I put 3 in the grid direction. Also 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so for each direction, the distance is 5, and then the distance here is 6. And then I have only one story. The story height is, I don't know, here we just didn't have, okay. We just keep the default value 3 meter, okay. Okay, 6, 6. And then we have slab that is okay here. Signal of the slab 110 feet, and then concrete strength 25. So we will define the material first. We add new material and then use 0 and then concrete. And then C25, concrete C25, 0. Keep default value C25, and then we define the slab section here. So our slab 120. Okay. Thickness. We add new property slab 120, and then material C25. So here I put the name of the slab 120, and then modeling tabs here. See, we have shell sin, shell sick, and more ground. Yeah. I never use that one. Okay, normally for the slab, we define we use shell sin. Shell sin, shin cell. Shell sin. And okay. And then to draw a slab, instead we have, you may have, for example, sometimes you draw it separately like this, and then or draw one whole panel. If there is a difference between these two kind of modeling, we have four separate panel, and then another option is you draw one panel, it is the same. Okay, as long as if you draw separately, each edge of the slab you connect to each other, it is the same. So you draw in one panel or four panel, finally the software will divide this panel into smaller element mesh. Okay, so each mesh connect to each other by node. Okay. And then we have the slab, so we have to make sure that thickness of the slab. See slab 120. Okay, and then we draw beam here. Beam. Okay. 30, 50. Okay, 30, 40. So here we define frame section. Here I will delete that I will not use. Okay, we add new beam here. Okay, so we use concrete C25 and then I put it B 30 by 50. Then width here 30, 50. Okay. And And then reinforcement here, you beam design. And then here, long steel no reinforcement. So we add new material, euro concrete rebar. Okay, and then you put one. In some size, some hand. Then new beam 400 depth and then 300. Okay, so here concrete and then B 30 by 40, and then reinforcement beam design FY 400. Okay, and then okay. And then we draw the beam B 30 by 50. Okay, from here to here, from here to here, here to here. And then beam 30 by 40. Okay, so beam section. Okay, okay. And then the column. Column here 300 by 300. Okay, so we define the column section 300, and then C35. And then here I put C for column. 30 cm by 30 cm. Okay, column, column, and then 400, 400. Okay. And here we don't need, because we will check slab only. Okay, so and then column. All we need, and then. Then the load C sharp now. So this one it means in addition to slab we have this dead load 5 kN/m². Okay. So I select the slab, assign shell load uniform dead load, and then I put 5, not -5 but 5, because here direction of the load is gravity. Not in like in Autodesk Robo, they put Z direction. So if put Z direction, we should put -5, okay, kiloton per square meter, and then replace existing load. So if you assign some load already on the panel, you put replace so that you don't have double load. Or you maybe you have already put, and then you forget that you already put it more, and then become double something. So you should keep it replace existing. Apply, and then you see this one over here. You say 5 in the middle. You don't have the load symbol for uniform load in the tab. So line load 2, apply, okay, close. And then what we'll do next? We will define. I will show you load pattern. Dead load. See cell bed here 1. Into the load, lie load, server factor 0. Okay. So this one is the load type, and then the load combination. You can use design here, and the slab design, and then combo at automatic load combination, this one for concrete slab design, and then convert to user combination editable. It means if we check the option, you can change the factor that generated by somewhere. So from here, they generate two load combination. For example, the second one, you can change this factor, dead load to 1.6, 1.7, up to you. And you can change this factor. So from here, so we have, I think we have all already. For the analysis, we don't need anything more. Okay. We run the analysis. Okay, this one, the deform shape or the structure. The first, to check your model, you can check what is easy to check is the check the deform shape or the structure. If it is reasonable or not, is it deformed like this? Because sometimes, for example, the software, they forget that, oh, there is one column here. They just consider that no column, and then the deflection line from here, downward here. So you know already, oh, there is something wrong in the middle here. But in this case, okay, so we have column here, column here, column here. So deflection should be like this. Okay. Drop, drop, drop like this. But you may think that, oh, the mesh is too much, too big. So maybe I want to reuse the size of the mesh to for example 0.5 meter, something like this. We change the model. Select this floor, and then assign shell, and then floor to my option. And then I will put set the size, maximum size of mesh to 0.5. Apply, okay, and then you want so okay, so this is the mesh 0.5 meter by the mode here 5 meter, so it must be 10, okay, is 0.5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so we have 10 elements. Here is 5. So 10 times 0.5 become 5. Okay. So here 6, so it must be 12 elements. 6 meter, 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 12. analyze this. Okay, so again. So now what's next? Okay, you see, you take a look into the result. Display, then shell stress force, okay, here for slab. Okay, so load combo, for example, I take into only load combo number 2. Bending moment, for moment is mm, so we have m11, m22, and then m12. So m11 is mhh, myy, m12 is mhy. But sometimes your panel is not aligned with X and Y direction. So in that case, you should pay attention. For example, you have a wall that is perpendicular to the plan X and Y. So in this case, you don't know Y go to where, X go to where. You should first let software display the local direction. So this one is aligned to local direction, it's not global direction. So share, so you check local apps. Okay, so here maybe I will show only share view, so only the share. Okay, so from here we know that app X and Y are the share. So X the same X and global axis, Y the same Y and global axis. Okay, for inclined panel shell structure that is not aligned to the global axis, X and Y here is not always the same as X and Y here. So when you look into the result here, X and Y here is X and Y in this local axis. It's not global. Okay, so for example, here I take a look at M11. So in this case, M11 is for the design reinforcement in with reinforcement, vertical or horizontal reinforcement in this case. Horizontal. So direction 1 is horizontal, so the reinforcement is horizontal. Okay, so we have. Okay, so the red here, you see the red here, the value is between something like this, and then the blue, what's the blue? Between 12. And then the unit is kiloton meter per meter. M11 come to 2 in another direction. So okay, now we look only M11, but we have M12 also. It's only M12. So you need to combine between, for example, for the design reinforcement in direction 1, you need to combine M11 with M12. So how to combine this here? For the calculation of positive moment, you should take, see here, for example, M11 equal, for the design reinforcement in direction 1, the M11 plus absolute value of M12. So you should add these two values. For example, here, for example, here, 13, M11. So you should read also M12 here. Okay. 0.3. Okay, so the total is 13.0.3. You see, they're nearly the same. That's why sometimes they just neglect it rightly. But is it the same if we check the reinforcement here? So here is 20.8, but M12 0. Okay. And then another thing to consider here. You need to, okay, so here is U, so object, and then we have beam also here. So the slab, the moment for design of the slab, we don't use value here, but yeah, value from here, at edge of the beam. Okay. Edge of the beam. And then also we have to consider the average value. It's not the value or the moment at one location. Average value. Okay. So we have to divide into column strip and middle strip. Okay. So if column strip here, you take 6 divided by 4, 6 divided by 4, the rest is 6 divided by 2. Okay, so we have to take the average over 3 meter here for the design or top reinforcement at the column or middle here, we have to take the 3 meter in the middle and then calculate the average value over this 3 meter. Okay. So how we calculate the average for the, on this panel? This panel. Okay, so I will take only 3 in the middle. So how to get 3 in the middle here? So I will take 6 divided by 4 is 1.3 to 1.5. Okay? So each panel here is 0.5, so I will skip 3 panels. 1, 2, 3, so I will start from here, from this, and then 3 meter, it is equal to 6 panels. So 1 panel is 0.5, so 6 panels from here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so I will take the average from here to here. And then, for example, if I take the average along this line, so I will take from this point, you read the value from this point, 12. Six times 0.05. 0.5 becomes 3. So here is 12. So 12.8. So here 10.5.
What is the average? How do you calculate the average? So, this pen here, this is all line here. So here is 10, then 12. What is average? Then you calculate the area, then you divide by the length. So here is 3. So what is the area here? So here is 0.5. Thank you.
If you consider unwanted poop also. So for your
home here is 1.5.
So here is 1.
Maybe
Or maybe I will complete this one for the example. And mình chưa nào anh click vào đây. Chưa đi. Rồi khẩu trước khẩu thứ. Chưa đi. Đi slide nhé. So here's the robot. But in the middle of the robot. See that this way, you have to calculate a lot, take a lot of time. And so when they have a tool that they have calculate for you directly in the algorithm. So how? So you have to calculate there. So how much when they do my thing here? So this is it. So we have draw a line here. So we have 1.5, 1.5. Okay. That is the middle of what is this? The line in the middle of this strip. So 1.5, 1.5. So that's how to do this. Up here. You got a 4, 1.5, 1.5. So how? So, Okay, so here you delete the result, and then we draw design strip here. Okay. Go to draw and then design strip. Design strip ni make column strip, middle strip. Column strip you cut down column. Karena bila column ni column strip. Okay, the strip you have strip in two direction, direction A and direction B. This is I, direction A, horizontal, direction B, what they call something like. Strip design type, column strip or middle strip. Okay, here middle strip. You see here 1.5, 1.5, left and right, and right the same. So we start the strip from here to here. So I will draw from here to here. Okay, so this one a strip. It means we will ask software to calculate the average on the strip. I will show how it is strip. So strip it. Okay, so here. We will close this one. So where we calculate the total movement on the strip. Okay, we run analysis again. This one and then display false, strip false, and then combo number 2 and then moment. You have only one strip and then here you have this one is total movement. Okay. So here for example, in the middle, here 36.5, something like this. 35.5. Okay, so from here, okay, and then you can, for example, for the design of the slab, you can select this slab and then go to design and then concrete slab design. There is UVY. Okay, we have it's on Eurocode already. See before country here because Eurocode you have Eurocode that is for France, UK, Belgium, something like that. So each country they have some special document for their country. You see here even Singapore they use Eurocode also. And then they have national document for Eurocode. So they redefine some safety factor, some provision inside Eurocode to their country. Okay, see and default they use a recommended value. You see in Eurocode sometimes they put oh this value equal to this one in valor recommended. And then you should see each country for each value defined each. For example here, alpha cc. See alpha cc for calculation or design strength of concrete SCD equal to alpha cc, SCK divided by gamma c. In standard value it is 1, but in British standard, British BS, they put 0.85, something like this. United Kingdom, 0.85. It's not, it means alpha cc is 0.85 times SCK divided by gamma c. But CN default, valor recommended is 1. NF, known from say 1 also. But British, 0.85 something. Then design, concrete slab design. So I don't know, never use that one, stick with. So rebar, we change to FY. with a strip. You like load, no reduction, okay. This one, okay. This one, and then go to design. And then I should start design. So this slab, we add story number one, okay. And then you have this one belongs to the non reinforcement. So here is 4 apart. So the unit in millimeter square per meter. Okay. And then add here how much? So from your design, how much? Yeah. Okay, so here why they put differently. So right click this one, show I don't know, they show just only this. I don't know what it is. 425. Nothing more. Design, slab design, display. Yeah, with this crack width calculation also. But we don't have a switch combination. Display flexural design. So here, what is this? Shear reinforcement and flexural reinforcement. So top bar, bottom bar, they are only this. For the design of the slab, see what are the criteria or consider from here, you can design that for your life, for a time little thing. Depends on a time little thing, on the day, when you're there. Define load combination, add new combo, linear edge, and then SLS for deflection. And then you have dead load and live load. So how dead load, the factor, how much? For deflection calculation. And then live load, residential building, deflection. 0.3. This one is combination quasi permanent. Sustained load combination. Combination quasi permanent. Deflection. Okay, come the zone call the now. Okay, and then we reuse in MC of the slab to 0.35. So I select the slab and then assign shell here and then stiffness modifier. And we reuse. You see here flexural stiffness M11, M22, M12. All of these I will reuse to 0.35. Okay, apply. So it means we reduce the inertia of the slab from EZ to 0.35 EZ for bending in both directions, X and Y. Okay. And then for beam, here I will assign, I will select all the beams, select, and then object tab, beam, select. So here I select all the beam, and then assign frame, stiffness modifier also, property modifier here, moment inertia. Okay, so here 0.3, 0.5, 0.5. I reduce the inertia in both directions, direction Y and Z. Talk show me. Okay, talk show if you want to reuse 0.1, 0.2 up to you. not that important. Okay, so now we will analyze this again and see if deflection is okay or not. So here, from deform shape here, load combo, SLS deflection. Okay, so from here, and then here. So the displacement in Z direction. For example, for slab here in the middle. Okay, so is it a problem or not in this case? So in the middle, is 1.8.
So we take the deflection of the slab. So you make up here in this direction. So here you go down a little bit. In this direction. Go down like this. So deflection. You want to have a deflection. Connect from the line from here.
So it's 1.5. Then from here it's 2.5.
So we have the slab like this here, go down 5, here 2.5, then here 3.5. So the new location of slab like this, so the location is going to be 1. From here to here, so it's a location. So I have to go on to 3.8 minus 5. This one is one deflection here. So what do you think? Is it okay or not okay? So here my turn. Now my device here. So this one is instant and last deflection. Why I start the name? That is every time, maybe around 3. In electric, what? 3, 4. 2, it is every 1 plus 3. Okay, so times 3. So in this case, if you have 34. And then you have additional number. That is IP and P here. So IP in form 2 and L 16. Okay? And then additional help you check with. Then you have your timing, you have a finishing the real that may be damaged by the user. Only finally, by one. And then. No. And then maybe sometimes you check on the direction of the when we find the slab, then our beam line. So the beam, one slab. But in reality, we can only offset the beam, we can have slab. And from here, our slab is made well. So when we define the slab, we want to have the middle of the slab line. This is finally the only. So if we want to meet like this, okay, so here square, we draw this one direction, so here, so right here, put the beam, offset the beam to this horizontal line. You see, it is just the horizontal line.
So from here, I will offset beam, offset the beam down. So we select the beam, select object tab, beam, okay, and then assign frame insertion point, and then we put top center, and then we uncheck this one. Then we put the
top center in, then we will offset slab beam, for example, slab, we will offset beam to.
I will use global axis here. Set a local, I put global. Here I put 60. 60 because the thickness of our slab is 120 divided by 2 is 60. Okay, if our slab is 10, we move only 50. Amen. Yeah. So top center and offset 60. Apply. Okay, and then now we run the analysis again to see if it will, if we do like this, it will improve the deflection or not. Okay, so from here we check the load combo, SLI deflection, and then deflection in Z direction. So here now it becomes 9. Okay, so reduce from 11 to 9.
So you offset the pin here become 9.2.
Become
2.3 plus 1.3. So now here become So the result is not improved very much. So it is why when we offset the limb, the limb measured on the wing will be reduced, will be reduced, but the slab in between the limb, so it will not affect very much on the slab. Okay, so this step, maybe all the way back. So how to improve the slab? So the equation is not fast out of it. So you can ask, you can relieve or you can increase the slab and compress in between the one. Or if you put second relieving, how do you put second relieving? In which direction?
Okay, we go here 30 by 50. Okay, secondary beam 30 by 40. Another beam here. So we will assign frame, this one insertion point, the same, apply, close, and then you inertia on this beam. Assign frame, stiffness modified, property modified, here, so the first 0.2 and then here, 0.5. Like low, you run analysis again to see the slab improve or not. So here, see now deflection of slab here become 4.4, and then here 2.9, 1.5. This one is 4.4 only. See, we check it will be okay. Thank you.